Happy Monday afternoon. I am usually with you on Monday mornings at 6:30 a.m. and it was not meant to be this morning. Technology was not my friend. I had to really direction, not perfection myself out of caring and just tell myself later. It's just going to happen later. And so that is why I am here now. My name is Lindsay House, dietitian, personal trainer, accountability coach, and author. Coming at you live every Monday to help hit that reset button and to really feel like you're going into the week strong and ready to take on whatever needs to be taken on. So thank you for joining me today. I'm really excited. You probably saw what I'd already mentioned in my previous post that today we are talking about personal trainers and their top daily habits. And this is where your homework's gonna stem from today. This is where it's one thing to read the article, and I felt like there's just so much more I wanted to pull out of it for you. So it was worth talking about it live. Before we go there, Juliana Fitzmaurice is the author of this blog, and I wanted to introduce you to her. One, I loved her post, and I'm sure there's many more like this that we can dive into. And she is part of this company called HomeFit. And as you can see, I'm sporting some HomeFit gear today because I thought it would be a nice little pairing with a direction, not perfection. They reached out and they stem from Birmingham and have locations in Huntsville and Nashville, Tennessee, and they are growing in Cincinnati now. And I get to be part of it. I'm honored to get to start consulting with this company. So what is HomeFit, right? What does this company do? They pair clients with a professional. So for instance, whether it's a personal trainer, PT, physical therapist, health coaching, dietitians, they're taking this client need and then matching them with the professional that they think is the best fit for them. And a lot of times with these clients, busy professionals, it can be the person who's like, I would love a trainer, but I can't go to the gym. I just don't feel like I have time for it. Busy moms, whatever in your head goes, oh, I need that. I need someone to just show up at my door. This company provides that, but they also provide virtual. So that's where I also come in because I do quite a bit of virtual consults. So I don't know, it's just exciting to be part of this amazing team. And I thank you. But if you start to see, you know, through my adventures, you're going to start to see me tagging HomeFit in there because we are pairing and I am consulting for them. And so if you're ever wondering, why am I all of a sudden seeing HomeFit on everything? It's because we're now a team. So here we go, right? Thank you. All right, let's dive into that article though. Personal trainers and their top daily habits. And one of the reasons why I really wanted to bring this up, because what came to your mind first when you thought, okay, what are trainers' top daily habits? My guess is that a lot of you initially went, oh, I bet somebody's fasting 2 days a week, you know, at minimum. I bet somebody's doing Whole30 every other month. I bet somebody's on some crazy strict workout regimen. I'm thinking your heads went to someplace more intense. Like their habits are gonna be hardcore and they never don't do them, right? They're non-negotiables. Well, that part might be true, but the hardcore part, the interesting part, and what I really want to highlight for you, and this was Juliana's highlight at the end of the article, was what she noticed that each of the trainers that she interviewed said was that hydration, movement, and gratitude were the three commonalities across each person's response to what is a daily habit. I'm going to say them again. We had hydration, movement, gratitude. Is there a piece of you that goes, ah, really? That's like the daily work that somebody's aiming for every day? That sounds nice. That sounds too easy. Too easy is one thing to say, and then another's to say, but are we all doing it? If it does sound too easy, are you doing it every day? Are you out loud Giving gratitude? Are you out loud being thankful every day? Are you easily hitting your water needs every day? Are you always finding that movement that makes you smile and that makes you want to keep going every day? And so I'm bringing that up because yes, it can sound easy, but the fact of the matter is a lot of us don't do this every day. A lot of us don't come down to something in general that we can like pinpoint and say that we do every day, which brings up this point that I wanted to read. So she states, we can't get what we want out of life from things that we only do once in a while. It's the things we repeatedly do, whether it's what we spend our time thinking about or what we spend our time doing each day. It's those things that ultimately make up who we are and how we feel and what we believe. Okay, so really the theme of this, when we talk habits, it means that it's something that is consistent, right? So that's a buzzword. Pull out your highlighter, consistency. And just think about it. It's nearly impossible to be consistent with something that's really hard to keep doing, right? So of course, if something's going to be a habit, my hope is it brings on the feeling of shoulders relaxed and, oh, I could do that. That's what you need to be saying. It's less about, for instance, again, within the article, each trainer has something different to say about what their specific habits were, but had the same thing to say about it was consistent. It was often. I guarantee when Juliana asked that question, that not one of those trainers had to say, I don't know what my daily habits are. I don't know what my health habits are. I guarantee that those came pretty fast to their head. They might have had to like think how to like put them down, but I don't think that they would have had to think then more than a few minutes of what are those ripple effects, like what we talked about last week, what starts their ripple into healthiness, what are those starters for them that make sure that their week stays aligned. And I'm bringing this up for you because it's really important to truly understand that. Like, I think health professionals are lucky sometimes because we talk about health all the time and it's always on the forefront of our mind, then it's always at the top of our to-do list, at the top of our priority list, right? Where if you're in a completely different profession, if it's not always in your visual line of sight, it's not always as easy to keep at that top of the priority list. So we have to keep other ripples or other habits in place to make sure that it accidentally stays there, that we don't have to think hard about it every day. And so one of the things, here's your homework, okay? One of the things I wanted you to do was I want you to write out your goals. Yes, for like the 100th time that I've asked you to write out your goals, do it again, okay? Humor me. Write out your why. Why are you caring about health? Your big why. And write out when you talk wants or you talk goals, write those back down because I want a list of those. And then if you can like visually see this, we have our list of goals and then I want your list of habits. I want you to visually see if any of these habits are starting already to align. For instance, these were some of my examples. Like let's say your goal is weight loss. One of your habits over here, you might say, I pack my lunch every day. Okay, that habit aligns with your goal of weight loss, right? And then you can do the opposite with it too. You can say, which habits aren't aligning with my goal? And you can really start to visualize like what needs change. So I keep saying this, but I feel like there's this like pie in the sky world. So the things that if everything went perfect in the day, if I had no barriers, this is what my strategy would look like, or this is what my habits would look like. But then there's the reality of what can be done in the day. And so what I want you to do though is do the pie in the sky. Do the what could feels unrealistic to you, but if you got to accomplish everything you wanted to in a day, what would that look like? Because now what we get to do off of that list is pull off, oh, maybe I can drink more water, or maybe I can fit in a little more movement at lunch or right after work if I pack my shoes, or maybe I just need to start packing my lunch. I'm eating out every day and I'm hungry by that point and my defenses are down, so I keep choosing poorly. Like my guess is there's always something small in that within those habits that actually seems feasible. But what you're also going to recognize are the things that don't seem feasible and that you go, I just don't have time for that in my life right now. I don't have the energy for that in my life right now. Okay. And I want you to see that because that's not what we're asking you to change. What we're asking you to change are the things that feel tangible, the things that you can really hold on to and do. Okay. And so, again, just to kind of recap, habit is about consistency. It's about doing it every day and coming right back to it. And even if I just had this conversation this morning with one of my favorite people, my photographer friend, and I can't wait. I went and met her because I got fun pics and I can't wait to show them to you. But she and I even like accidentally ended up in this conversation that habit is about showing up and doing it every day, even when we are not necessarily like inspired to do it or in the mood to do it, because I know I'm totally guilty of this. I can 100% wait to get inspired to like sit down and do what needs to get done. And life doesn't really work like that, right? So what's helped me are very consistent to-do lists, things that I know that X, Y, and Z need to happen today. Whether I'm inspired to do it or not, it's happening. And so just kind of keep your brain around that too. But consistency, all right? And that consistency will start to build on itself. But your homework today is we need to build habits that align with your goals. Habits are not aligning with your goals. Let's go back to that. I want to lose weight and I'm not packing my lunch. Let's put that in there. That habit of not packing lunch is not aligning with weight loss. Okay. Or I'm not eating breakfast is not aligning, or I'm not packing my tennis shoes to get in that workout after work. These are all accidental habits that aren't happening, where like maybe if we can visually see it on paper, we can see that we could start to flip-flop some of those and just make them better align with those goals. Okay. So we're just today, if you got nothing out of today's talk, it's that we're aiming for our habits to align with our goals, and that when you seek out professionals such as this crew that responded and personal trainers and their top daily habits, it's nothing crazy. It isn't. It's all doable and manageable habits that they can repeat every day that helps the ripple effect, that helps the next behavior, that helps the next behavior, that all of a sudden alignment is intact. So, all right, that's my spiel for you today. Thank you so much for joining me and letting me introduce you to this awesome home fit company. You're gonna love once you get to really know them. Great people, and I'll share some of their really fun, inspirational, thankful talks, and I'll be kicking stuff your way. But don't forget, if these talks ever inspire you, please feel free to share them, to hit the like button, to pass them forward if you think they could help somebody else in their day. I also have a handful left of my Direction, Not Perfection books that if you would like to gift one over this holiday season, I would love to inscribe and pour some love into somebody's inscription for them so that you can have that personalized and give that out. I also have gift certificates. If you would like to do a package of accountability sessions for anyone, please let me know on that or reach out to me privately. But just thank you for your time, and love seeing you pop up. Like I always tell you, you're the ones that inspire me and get my week set. I'm telling you, because this morning didn't work, I feel like I've been kind of off, and it feels so good. I hope this is still taping. It feels so good to show back up and just reset. Now my Monday's back in alignment, and we can move on with our week. So, okay, have awesome weeks. Thank you, HomeFit. I love my gear. And see you later.